my best form of communication is art, is visual, because it talks directly to the heart. And I think if people's hearts come together, people will overlook the fact that they're really not communicating that well. I have found a support for this belief when I brought my art to Japan, because while I can't speak the language, we communicate very well. They love my art, and therefore they seem to like me, and it goes both ways. When I get to tour Japan, it truly is a tour. It's not like in America where an art show is in one gallery and all the people are invited to come to it. But rather, when we go to Japan, I guess the idea is to get the art to as many people as possible. So if I'm there for 2 weeks, we will have 14 shows or more, sometimes two a day. And it is very hard. We're on the train, we're on airplanes, we're in cars all day long to get to a show. And then a show will go on for hours while I get to meet and talk to the people. But there's the reward. As hard as it is, and it's very difficult for an introvert to be around so many people and to travel every day like that. But when I get to meet the people and see the grins on their faces, and I guess what comes to mind is when people, again, they're telling me why they bought the painting, and somebody will be standing there crying in front of one of my paintings, and I can't believe it. I'll say, why are you crying? He says, this is the happiest day of my life. Or a young couple saying, we're getting married next year, and this is our wedding presents to ourselves. Or some beautiful old grandmother saying, this is for my family. I'm going to leave it to them as their inheritance. And you know, it's like, to the Japanese people, art is really the jewel. A number of people that have bought the paintings have explain to me that they go to a hard day's work, and they don't see the birds and the bees and the trees and the blue sky. They just work all day, like most people in the world, to get along. And when they come home, it may not be the fanciest of homes, but the Japanese people seem to be able to focus in on art. And they say that the painting they're buying from the Grand Prix Gallery and from my hand is really the center of their homes. They come home and they can sit down in front of my painting and they get peaceful, and it returns to them their power and their spirit and their strength, and makes their life feel worthwhile. I'm getting to know a lot of the people because they come back every time. But many people seem to be decorating their lives with my work, because now that I've been there a dozen times or something, they have 3 and 4 paintings in their homes. So yeah, a lot of repeat customers and repeat friendships. I mean, to me, I'm utterly humbled by the experience of the Japanese people, that they're so appreciative of art. But I've always felt art was next to godliness, because it's about creativity and truth and beauty. And I think that's about as close as you can get to God, and I think the Japanese people feel the same way.
What's important about my life, I suppose, would be the question you would ask when you're making a documentary. And while I'm not making it, it's about me. And as far as what I think, my life, I think, is important to other people only in as much as I began from the ground level. And I worked my way up one step at a time up that high mountain to my dreams. And I think my life proves that no matter how humbly you start, you can reach the stars and you can make your dreams come true. And I think by other people seeing a life that worked out that way can give us hope, can give us encouragement that we can all attain to our dreams. If I can do it, anybody can do it.